Here's a question I get asked often. Is it possible to plug two microphones into one DBX286S unit? Well, the answer simply is, yes, it is, but is it practical? Not really. So you'd need to get two male XLR cable into one TRS cable. So you've got your XLRs here for your microphones. So you'd plug one XLR into one mic, one into the other, and then you'd use the splitter end here, which would go into the line input on your DBX286S. That way you're sending two microphone signals into one DBX286S unit. Only problem with doing it this way is you now only have control over a single signal. You can't control both signals independently. So things like noise gate and everything will react to both microphones. So when you're talking, the other microphone's audio will also be heard. Not an ideal situation. Also, setting up the enhancer, like the low frequencies and the high frequencies, usually you want to do that individually for each person, okay? So a splitter cable is not really the best idea, even though it's practical. There are so many other things like de-essing. Well, sibilance is at a different place in everyone's voice. And compression, well, you probably add the same amount of compression to each voice, but there you go. That's why I suggest not just getting one DBX286S, but actually getting two DBX286Ss and doing it that way. Yes, it's a little bit more expensive, but I think for the fine grain control you can have, and if you're doing a professional podcast or broadcast where it's essential to get the best sound possible, my solution is to get the DBX286S times two. Oh, wait. This is the DBX 166XS. There it is. I'm going to have to start building a rack to contain all these DBXs, but they really are good for the live processing of voice, whether it's for podcast, broadcast, singing, you name it. So the DBX 166XS actually has two channel inputs. Yes, that's right, two channel inputs. If you want to process a stereo signal, you can do that by hitting stereo couple there. There's a stereo couple button, and then it just bases it off the settings you put on channel one. But if you've got two microphones, ideal. XLR into channel one, XLR into channel two from both mics, you can process them independently. It's missing a couple of things that the DBX286S has, such as the de-essing facility and the enhancer, the EQ facility as well. But compression is there, noise gate, expander, it's all there. So most of the stuff you can do with the DBX286S is there. Although if I had a preference for purity of sound, I'd definitely get DBX286S times two. I'm not just saying that, I would. One more thing you can do with the 166XS, if you have those two separate signals processed independently, once you return those signals into your audio interface or your mixing console, assuming you've got some EQ on your mixing console, most Soundcraft desks have that, you can then separately EQ both channels on your mixing console. So you kind of get the best of the enhancer facility over there on your mixing console. So that could be something to consider too. And that is how you process one, two, three, or more microphone signals using DBX units.